Good morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody. We thank you, Jesus, God. We thank you, Lord. Oh, God, we give you all the glory. Oh, God, we give you all the honor, God. Thank you, honey. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. Good morning, y'all. Y'all, it's time for second service. You'd have had to be on Facebook to know what I mean when I talk about second service. Listen, y'all, can we just, I got to start this off worshiping because today is going to be a day of the prophetic. And today is going to be a day of just, we just about to see the clouds about to empty themselves. Can I just go ahead and prophesy over your life that every cloud that's been holding up rain in your life, every cloud that's been holding back rain in your life, can I go ahead and speak to your cloud today? Can I go ahead and prophesy to it today and go ahead and decree and declare that it's getting ready to empty itself? So as we get ready, I need for you to get up and I need for you to worship. Now, if you at work, I understand. But besides that, I just need for you to decrease some stuff, okay? Ooh, hallelujah, Jesus. We thank you, God. Oh, God, I thank you, God. I thank you, God. I thank you, God. Give me just a moment. Oh, rababa shete rababa sata rababo rabake. I keep waiting. I keep waiting. Oh, rababa shete raso rabaki. Oh, rabake rabasa rababa shete rababa.
I can't.
to let you in on a good insight. I need for you to realize something about your life. Can we just realize something about our lives? Can I just go ahead and speak? See, let's turn off the music for a second. Can I just go ahead and decree and declare over your life that you ain't seen nothing yet? Listen, I need for my day ones to get all my other day ones in here, because I know y'all got that thing going on where y'all invite each other and make sure everybody's here. See, listen, I need for you to understand something. You have not, and I'm passionate about this thing. Why I'm passionate about this thing? Because I'm feeling it in the name of Jesus. I just can, it's in my belly, it's in my bones, it's in my mouth, it's in my mind, it's in my reality. Can I go ahead and say that it shall be your reality? See, you've been confessing some things, but it's not just we're speaking these things to speak them. No, we are speaking our reality. This is the reality that we live in, baby. This is the reality we live in. Why you on 10, Takiya? Why you not on 10? Let me ask you a question. Why you ain't on 10? Why you so loud, Takiya? Why you ain't loud? Your situation loud, them creditors loud, them debts loud, the bank account, when they calling you about your negative account, they loud. Maybe you need to get loud. Because can I say something to you? Oh God, I just want to say this, and I got to put this as a t-shirt in Bougie Sis Boutique. Y'all see I'm rocking Bougie Sis Boutique right now. See, I need you to know something. Loud voices still cause Jericho walls to fall. Loud voices still cause walls to fall. Loud voices still cause walls to fall. See, Jesus said that I need for you to lift up your voice. He didn't say, I need you to just do it quietly. See, I remember a man in the Bible who he shouted all the louder. He shouted all the more. And because he kept shouting all the louder and shouting all the more, even when his enemies were saying he should be quiet. See, some of you let the devil get you quiet. See, some of you let your enemies talk you out of your praise. Because what you don't realize is that praise could have been the very thing that broke the back on the devil, broke the back on your debt, broke the back on that thing you've been going through. But because you let somebody talk you out of putting on your praise, you just said, oh, I don't want to offend nobody. I don't care if you offended. Why? Because my poverty's offending me. It's bothering me. So I'm going to get as loud as I got to get, because I can't be worried about you and your offense, because I got my own stuff going on. So I got to lift up a shout. I got to lift up a praise. I got to get crazy about this thing. I got to give God all the glory, because I know that it's in my praise that Jericho wall come down. Oh, Rabashite Rababasa. Rombo bosu rambake. Robo sutu rambaba. Renka se. Hallelujah, God. God, I thank you, Jesus. God, I give you praise today. God, if I gotta jump, I'll jump. If I gotta shout, I'll shout. God, if I gotta get on my knees for this thing to break. See, you gotta get to the point where you get so You like, it gotta break. Oh, it do gotta break, Jess. Oh, it do gotta break, Stacia. Oh, it do gotta break, Kelly. Oh, it does have to break, V. I don't care if I gotta sweat while looking good. I ain't worried about that. I don't care. Because it's gotta break. So, God is about to break something in your life, and I need for you to get excited, because God, today is breaking day. You know what I mean? Like, When it's that day when they finna break ground on your property, and that's like the most exciting day, because breaking ground is symbolic that we're getting ready to build. See, what you don't realize is that in order for God to build, he has to break ground in your life. See, what if the reason why the God and there's things breaking in your life is because you're getting ready to break ground? See, can I go ahead and prophesy that the breaking is symbolic that you're getting ready to build? See, God has to break that thing. See, the ground has to be broken in order to establish the foundation that the house needs to keep standing. Are you rocking with me? See, they have to break ground so they can establish the foundation that is needed to build the house. See, I just need for you to go ahead and look at the brokenness a little bit different. See, because listen, broken vessels still give praise. Broken hearts are still near to God. Come on, my Bible says that God is near, that God is near the brokenhearted. See, broken hearts are still near to God. See, you look at your brokenness right now, and it just seems like everything's falling apart. But see, what I found is, in order for me to build a new house, if there's all these trees surrounding the area I want to build, I gotta cut some trees down. And when I'm cutting those trees down, it looks like the land is falling apart. It looks like the trees are falling apart. It looks like everything is falling apart. But see, the falling apart is necessary if I want to build in that area. See, the reason why it looks like things are falling apart is because God is getting ready to build in that very area. So in order for God to build in that area, he must clear the land first. Because when you're building a house, you gotta clear that land out if you want to build first. Because you don't, ooh, hallelujah, I gotta just go ahead and get close to you on this time. Because if you want to ensure that no trees grow up under that foundation, if you want to make sure that no weeds, come on, somebody got some weeds up in my house today. See, listen, sometimes, not sometimes, all the time, God has to make sure that he clears out the land, because God wants to make sure that no more weeds can grow up in that place. No more unnecessary trees can grow up in your foundation. So we must clear the land in order to ensure that nothing that could be detrimental to the house. We got to make sure that nothing that could be detrimental to the house is still there. So God has to remove anything that he knows that could be detrimental to the house. See, I need for you to know, what if the reason why God removed that friend is because she was detrimental to the house that God's getting ready to build in your life? What if the reason why God is removing habits, removing mindsets? See, God had to remove the poverty mindset because he couldn't build prosperity in your life if you still had that mindset. So God says, I gotta go in and create in you a clean heart. Come on, some people that would dare say, God created me a clean heart. See, God has to go into that area and he has to clean that heart out so he can put the right things in. Come on, it's hot in this room. See, God is clearing it out, y'all. See, God's been clearing it out. God's been clearing stuff out of your life. God's been removing some stuff. God's been coming up in there. See, you got to be very, very, very watchful when you say, God, clean it out. Because, see, God will have you going around your house throwing away stuff that you want to hold on to. Oh, God, well, I don't want to let that go. But, see, God says, you don't want to let that go, well, then that means you're not ready for me to bring new stuff in. See, the reason why you can't let it go, the reason why you don't want to, see, you want God to bring in the blessing, but you don't want to get rid of the stuff that God to get rid of in order for God to bring it in. So God says, I need for you to remove this stuff out of your closet if you want me to be able to have. See, listen, God has to get you to remove stuff in your closet to make room for the new clothes. Come on. God has to remove stuff in your closet in order to get ready for the new clothes. Because if there's no room, where I'm going to put the new clothes in? If there's no room, God, how am I going to see you want your kingdom husband, but you need to make room. You want the right friends, but you got to make room. You want new business ideas, but you got to make room. You want prosperity, but you got to make room. You want the overflow, but you got to make room. Because see, here's the thing. God says he needs room because see, God, in order for him to make room for new things to come into Abraham's life, he needed Abraham to release everything else that would consume that place. See, then I'm taking over into Mark chapter 10. I believe it's verse 28 and 29, where Peter began to say, Jesus, we left everything for you. We left our houses. We left all that stuff. Jesus, we left everything. But then Jesus replied to Peter. He said, listen, you really ain't left nothing. See, I'm paraphrasing this. You really ain't left nothing. Because what you don't realize is this. Everything you left was just trash that needed to be taken out. Why are you over there crying over trash? Can we just sit? Let's just sit for a moment. Why are you over there crying over trash? Why are you over there worried about trash? Why are you over there in your bed, can't even get up and put your clothes on because you over here worried about spoiled milk, baby, when God still got cows in the field? Can I just make a declaration? I will not cry over spoiled milk when I know my God still got cattle in the field. See, you over here crying over things like that's the end all be all. You still over here worried about stuff like it's the end all be all. Is God not able? Come on, is God not the God that says in Ephesians 3:20 that I am able to do exceedingly and abundantly? See, listen, you over here crying about the unnecessary and God is over here wanting to do exceedingly. You over here caught up in the unnecessary. You over here caught up in the mediocrity. You over here crying over the spoiled milk when God is over here still doing great things. Y'all, Shay said, I just told my grandfather this yesterday. I was in the streets acting like pastor. Listen here, Shay, you better go out there and just be acting like you up in these Jesus streets. And you just don't even care. See, listen, you stick around long enough, you'll be over here preaching to your grandfather. Come on, Shay. Shay is living proof. See, listen. Y'all, that we ain't even started yet. Can I read you a scripture? Can I read you a scripture? Because I need for you to know what the word of God says. I just need for you to know what the Bible has said and what has already been said about your situation. Then it ain't just a matter of what I'm saying. Oh gosh. Let me read you this scripture. Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 3 and 4. When the clouds are full of water, come on somebody. When the clouds are full of water, it rains. Come on. When the clouds are full of water, it rains. She said, y'all, he was quiet in the car after I gave him that word. I told him I got a new pastor. See, sometimes it just takes a new pastor in your life to cause you to start bringing out these gifts you never knew you had. See, sometimes it takes God bringing in the right people for you to start doing the right thing. See, can I go ahead and just spin the block? Did I just want to honor my spiritual mother and father, Prophet Hubert Angel and Prophetess BB Angel? Because see, it wasn't until God put them in my life that I could prophesy on such a level. See, there was a lady who's in my mentorship and she said, God, I don't understand how Pastor Takiya can just go name by name and just prophesy like that, because we're used to prophecy being like take 10 minutes on you. But see, I've watched my spiritual father just go hurry and boom and boom and boom and boom and boom and boom and boom. See, it takes the right people in your life to start unlocking something in you where all of a sudden you be like Lady Lou Latoya, where you just start praying a little bit different, where all of a sudden it just starts unlocking something. See, God says, I have given you spiritual shepherds after my own heart, that they may teach you and bring you knowledge, and that they may bring judgment and correction. See, all it takes is the right people in your life to unlock gifts. So I pray that you've been unlocked today. So Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 3 and 4 says, when the clouds are full of water, it rains. Oh, I don't know about you, but I just feel like it's getting ready to rain on somebody's life. I just feel like it's getting ready to rain on somebody's life. See, God says when your clouds are full of water, it rains. When the clouds are full of water, see, we've been loading up our clouds. When you pray, you're loading it up. When you praise, you're loading it up. So we've been loading it up. And I'm just excited because I can hear the rain. Come on, I can hear the rain. It says when the winds blow down a tree. When the clouds blow down a tree. No, when the winds blow down a tree, it lies where it falls. See, God is about to blow some things in your life. And I just believe that there are some trees of prosperity, some trees of healing. There's some trees that's about to fall on you. But see, it's okay. Because see, I'm okay with the right things falling on me. Oh God, I just thank you, Father God. Then it says, but this is what I love about God. This is what I love about God. God say, don't sit there watching the wind. Do your own work. God says, don't be sitting there just watching. Do something. Get up and do something. God say, don't just sit there watching the wind. Do your own work. He says, don't stare at the clouds. Get on with your life. Don't just be sitting there just looking, but go ahead and do something about it. Go ahead and start speaking to the clouds and say, clouds, I thank you that rain shall fall upon me. God, I thank you that there's something getting ready to happen in my life. There's something getting ready to break in my life. There's something that's getting ready to take place in my life. See, I'm excited. I'm really excited because God's about to do something. So it says, Amos 9:13-15, and this is my message today. And after this, we're just going to go into whatever God has for us today. Amos 9:13-15, can you flood my chat? Can you flood the chat with Amos 9:13-15? I want to thank you, Chanel, for sending me the roses. Amos 9:13-15, hey Chantel. It says, yes indeed, it won't be long now. You've been waiting, haven't you? You've been wondering, haven't you? You've been wondering when it was going to happen, haven't you? I know. He says, yes, indeed, Ariana. I feel that for you, boo. He says, yes, indeed, Ebony. Yes, indeed, Linda. I just need to put your name in it because I need for you to know that it's for you. Yes, indeed, Samantha. Yes, indeed, Nina. Yes, indeed, April. Yes, indeed, D'Angela. Yes, indeed, Chanel. Yes, indeed, Scoop Don't Stop. Yes, indeed, Diana. Yes, indeed. Let's talk about the word indeed. Because sometimes I feel like when you really know what a word means, it just brings way more understanding to your situation. God says, yes, indeed. What does the word indeed mean? The word indeed means it is used to emphasize a statement or a response confirming something already suggested. So indeed, it's used to confirm something already suggested. The word indeed is a word that is, it means, indeed means that it is confirming something already suggested. So when I say yes, indeed, Ebony, I'm saying, yes, Ebony, I'm confirming something already suggested. I'm confirming that God has already told you that it's going to work out. I'm confirming that God has already said you're healed. I'm confirming that God has already said your marriage is healed. I'm confirming that God already said that you are a multi-billionaire. Oh, she went there today. I'm going there today. If you wanted me to come for thousands, go to a different life. If you wanted for me to just come for your rent, go to a different place. Why? Because I'm the kind of pastor who knows that God pays off houses. I'm the kind of pastor that God that knows that I got a sister on my live today, because praise God for good memory. That I got a sister on my live today who's believing God to give her a 2021 Jeep Compass that is red with black exterior. So red with black trim. And that they are believing God, and I believe the rims are black also. And they're believing God for a Jeep Compass Trailhawk. Am I correct? Am I correct that I got a sister on here, Jordan, who's, but I don't forget nothing. See, I got some sisters on her who's believing God for healing for cancer. I got some sisters on her that's believing for some mansions, don't I? I got some sisters on her who's believing God for their family, for their marriage to get back together. I got some sisters on her who believe in God that the next book they're getting ready to write is a best-selling author. I got some sisters on her who's believing God for their kingdom man. Come on, all of my women who's believing that God's going to bring you a man who loves you like Christ loves the church. Come on, somebody, that God loves you the way that Christ loves the church. So when I say yes, indeed, I'm saying yes. I'm confirming that it's already been told to you that it won't be long now. But see, this is where I gotta camp out for a second. It doesn't just say that this is a word from anybody. It doesn't just say that it's just that this is a Pastor Takiya word. No. God goes enough to say something bold and crazy. Because when God puts his stamp of approval on it, when God backs that word up, he's saying something bold and crazy. And it says, yes, indeed, it won't be long now. God's decree. Notice how it says God's decree. Not Takiya's decree, not Jordan's decree, not Ebony's decree. It says God's decree. So God is saying everything I'm getting ready to say is backed up by me. This is a check that you can write and know when you go to the bank, it's going to check out. It's going to cash. This is something you can go and know that it's going to work out. So he says, God's decree, Irene. Irene, the Lord is telling me to tell you something. I'm just going to tell you right now. I heard what the Lord told me to tell you before I went to tell you. So what I'm about to say, Irene, is going to probably, you know what? The word don't need no explanation. I'm going to be obedient to what God told me to do. Irene, the Lord began to speak to me. He said, Takiya. He said, Irene has a poverty mindset, and that's why it's difficult for her to receive from me. He said, the reason why Irene is struggling financially is because she has a poverty mindset. And God says, if you want to receive what he has for you, you got to renew your mind. Because your mind is what's blocking you from getting everything that God has for you. And God says, when you renew, and God says, you sit here and hear the word, but you don't always apply what you heard. Somebody said $780. Oh, I know you. Pam A said $780 was deposited into both my gas and electric bills. Come on, Pam A. $780 just got deposited into her. Listen, can I just go ahead and say something? See, I don't know about everybody else's room, but I do know about what God does in Takiya Arevalo Ministries. So I can't speak for anybody else, but what I do know is this. You can get healed at any given time in this service. You can get healed at any given time in this room. You can go ahead and get miracle money. $1,000 can just hit your bank account and you not even be nowhere to trace that money at. Why? Because we a different breed. Takiya, that sounds like you're being cocky. The Bible says if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation in Christ. What does that mean? That means I'm a different breed from you. That means I'm not the same Takiya that I once was. Listen, V, who's one of my peoples, she said my credit went up and currently past due on my accounts. Come on. Your credit just went up. We've had people who have had their credit score go up 100 points. Where they do that at? We've had people whose credit went up 50 points. Where they do that at? See, we serve the God that can touch your credit. Well, where is it in the Bible? The Bible says, greater works shall ye do. That's where it's at. It's where God said, greater works shall you do. That means that things that you don't see her, you will be able to do. Najwa said her credit went up 34 points out of nowhere. That's because we declare it. God, Ebony said, God just be God. Because we let God do what he wants to do. It ain't that I'm here to do what I want to do. I don't prepare my messages. Why? Because I like to be led by the Lord. So when I come here and preach to you, I just need for you to know that the reason why you would hardly ever see me preach with notes, because we give fresh manna. I don't need to sit there and practice this preaching. Why? Because I know that God is on the inside of me and I let God do whatever he wants to do. So I don't practice this. I don't rehearse. I'm not practicing or rehearsing this. We get up in there and whatever God does is what he does. And that's just how we roll up in here. We just let God do whatever he wants to do. So God be God in her, because this ain't rehearsed. This ain't practice. I'm not sitting up here. I don't know half or none about nobody here. We just do whatever God wants to do. So I got to read a testimony I just seen somebody say. Hallelujah. Somebody said, my car insurance was paid in full, $418. Somebody said my car insurance was paid in full for $418. Jesus. So listen, you can get healed at any given time. We've had people in this ministry. I spoke a word. I said, there's a lady here who is getting ready to, there's a lady here and you're in a wheelchair and God is going to cause you to walk. You know, this lady got up out of the wheelchair and walked, then got on our live here and walked in front of everybody. I remember Miss Vita. I've seen people's children, prayed over people's children, and their child was getting ready to have surgery on their leg, and then they go to the doctor, and they literally tell that lady, your daughter's leg looks like it's completely new. Like they're completely fine. There's nothing wrong anymore. See, the God that we serve, you can get healed. It's always a healing service. It's always time for God to heal you. You at any given time. Come on, at any given time, you can get healed. Come on, Jersey, you healed in Jesus' name. He says by his stripes, you are healed. It's already done. So I just need for you to catch it by faith and say, God, I thank you that I am healed. God, your word says I am healed. So God, I receive it by faith. God, can I just testify? Maria said, God bless my husband with a new job. He is getting paid $35 an hour plus a sign-on bonus. Come on. $35 an hour plus the sign-on bonus. So God says, things are going to happen so fast, your head will swim. Listen, I just need for you to understand something, that everything is going to be happening all at once. And I know it's going to be different than you've ever had it before, because you used to the little trickle of a blessing. But see, I serve the God of the overflow. See, God is transferring you. God is moving you from just where you see just a little dripping faucet to where you're about to see it's like your pipes are busting. I prophesy to every pipe in your life that's been held up and say that it shall burst forth in Jesus' name. That it shall burst forth. That your water is about to just begin to burst out. Can I tell you that you shall have a pipe bursting blessing? That God is about to bless you in such a way that it's going to burst out. Listen, I just need that if any given time God blesses you, just go ahead and just let us know what God has done. Because we just see some people, the reason why we do testimonies is because testimonies build faith. He says you overcome by the word of your testimony. See, it builds faith to somebody else to know that God is a miracle worker. Listen, I just need for you to go ahead and run down the hall. I just need for you to just run down the hall. It ain't I'm about to run down the hall. Come on, you need some people that's running with you, baby. Somebody said, my credit went up 115 points. Come on, God. Somebody said, my credit went up 113 points. Hey, Naima. Welcome back. I know who you are. That is so funny. God, you are funny. God, you are funny. If you only knew, if y'all only knew. I'm gonna say something. Naima? I forgive you. I forgive you for the way that you came against me and the way that you came against my team. And I could block you right now after what you did to my people. But it is only by the Spirit. Woo, we ain't gonna even let that. Woo, Lord, I thank you, God. I thank you, God. God, we give you glory, Father God. God, I praise you, Father God. God, you are a good, good father. I bless you, Naima. I bless you, Naima. I thank you, God. I thank you, Jesus. Y'all, whew, some people know. Now, let me go read these testimonies. Glory be to God. Praise God. We thank you, Jesus. Lady Lou said, I haven't had customers in 2 weeks since Sunday, and they are coming in. Come on, God. God, I thank you for my new house. Come on. Come on, Ariana. Tell me. I want to know. I thank you, Jesus, God. Whoo. Praise God. I thank you, Jesus. I just want you to speak the name of Jesus. I just want to speak the name of Jesus. I just want to speak the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. We thank you, Father God. So it says things are going to happen so fast your head will swim. Things are going to happen so fast your head will swim. It says one thing fast. Can everybody just start speaking the name of Jesus? I need y'all because there's something to it. Speak the name of Jesus. Come on, speak the name of Jesus. Hey, Laura. Hey, Laura. Speak the name of Jesus. Just do it in the chat. Everybody, speak the name of Jesus. Oh, I just want to speak the name of Jesus. God, we thank you, God. God, we thank you for the name of Jesus, who is the name above every single name. God, I thank you that the name of Jesus causes darkness to flee. God, I thank you, Jesus. 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 Oh, I thank you, Jesus. Oh, I thank you, Jesus. There's a reason why I'm speaking the name of Jesus. There's a reason why I'm speaking the name of Jesus. Because Nama, you're right. We don't serve the same God. I don't know what God you serve. But I serve God. And I serve Jesus. And see, demons just want entertainment. Demons just want entertainment. And there's a reason why we're speaking the name of Jesus. Because I just want you to speak the name of Jesus as well. You serve God. Speak the name of Jesus. Speak the name of Jesus. Oh, rababa sata rabako rambaba. Rombo su ramba ke debaso. God, we speak the name of Jesus. We speak the name of Jesus. And I just want, if we serve, you serve Jesus. Speak his name then. Come on, you serve Jesus, right? Speak the name of Jesus then. Oh, God, I thank you for the name of Jesus. God, I thank you for the name of Jesus. We say Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord over our lives. Jesus is Lord over our minds. Jesus is Lord over our finances. Jesus is Lord over our families. See, I thank you for the blood of Jesus. Come on. I thank you for the blood of Jesus. I thank you for the blood of Jesus. Oh God, I thank you for the name of Jesus. The name above all names. See, the Bible says, oh ramba seda baso ramba ka, rumba boso ramba ke. Speak the name of Jesus. Come on, speak the name of Jesus, Nama. Speak the name of Jesus. That's all I'm asking you to do. Just speak the name of Jesus. Because listen. Come on, you say all that and speak the name of Jesus. Oh, rambaba sata rababa so rambaba. Rambaba selembrakodo rambaba. God, I thank you for the name of Jesus. There's a reason to this. Oh, God, I thank you for the name of Jesus. I thank you, God, for the name of Jesus. Thank you. I just want you to decree that name above every name, that name. Oh, she's still probably here, but I just need for her to speak the name of Jesus, because see, I can speak the name of Jesus. I serve Jesus. Oh, rambaba sata rabake. Oh, God, I thank you, Jesus. 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 See, God is breaking something right now. 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 Honey, come over here. Oh, rambaba sata rababa so rambaba. Rombobo suramba ke deba so ramba ke. Thank you for the name of Jesus. Thank you for the name of Jesus. Thank you for the name of Jesus. Ha ramba se a ramba ke deba so rambaba. Rombo so rambaba. Ronko so ramba ke deba so ramba ke. Let me read you a scripture. Let me tell you why, because I know a lot of you could be, it's probably thinking like, Pastor, don't. But I'm going to tell you why. Now say Jesus. Say Jesus, because the Bible says, no man can come to the Father unless through him. You can't even get to God unless through his son, Jesus. So say Jesus. Let me tell you why I'm saying the name of Jesus scripturally. 1 John chapter 4 verse 2 says this. By this you may know, perceive, and recognize the Spirit of God. It says every spirit which acknowledges and confess the fact that Jesus Christ the Messiah actually has come as a man and has come in the flesh is of God, has God for its source. It says, in every spirit which does not acknowledge and confess that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh. And then it says, but would annul, destroy, sever, and disunite him is not of God, does not proceed from him. This non-confession, notice what the Bible says. He says this non-confession is the spirit of the Antichrist. I'm not blocking the devil today, ain't he? You know why? Because, ain't he, David didn't block Goliath. I'm not blocking it today. I'm standing up to this thing today because I need that demon to know on the inside of you that I'm not scared of you, devil. I am not scared by one inch, not one factor, none. Why? Because I understand the name. There was a time when I wouldn't stand up. There was a time when I would just block you. But baby, I'm not blocking you today because I need for what that's on the inside of you to understand the God on the inside of me. It gets gritty for that thing. I'm not backing down today. I'm not. I'm speaking the name of Jesus. I'm not fighting you. I'm just speaking the name above every name. I'm just speaking Jesus. That's all I got to say. All I got to say is the name of Jesus. That's the only thing I got to say. I'm not going blow for blow. All I got to say is Jesus. So he says this non-confession is the spirit of the Antichrist, is of which you already that is coming, and now it is already in the world. See, your inability to say the name of Jesus just shows me something. It just shows me something. Jesus is Lord. Jesus, see, Jesus. God says that if you cannot say that name, it shows who you are. So God, I just want to speak the name of Jesus. And I just want to thank you, Jesus. So I need everybody to just begin to decree that name. Because when we decree that name is symbolic of what's backing us up. That name is an indicator of who you are and where you come from. So I just say Jesus is Lord. Jesus is the name above every name. Jesus is the name above every. See, Jesus is the name above Allah. Come on. Jesus is the name above Allah. And at the name of Jesus, every single demon shall tremble. Every darkness has to flee. Come on, let's just go ahead and worship, y'all. Let's just go ahead and speak the name of Jesus, y'all. We just want to thank you, God, that Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Come on, Jesus. See, can I tell you something? Every David has a Goliath. And if you only knew, but we just speak the name of Jesus. We just speak the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. This is warfare. This is what warfare looks like. We speak in the name of Jesus. Come on, Jesus.
I just want to speak the name.
I just want to speak the name.
Over every heart and every mind.
I just want to speak the name.
Because I know there is peace within your presence. I speak Jesus.
Come on, I speak Jesus.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus.
Come on, speak the name.
To every
Jesus is powerful.
Shout Jesus from
shout it.
Jesus in the streets. Jesus in the darkness over again.
Come on.
Jesus for my family.
Jesus for my family. Come on. Hallelujah. Something different about my room. Y'all notice something different about the room. Have y'all noticed a shift?
Even when I'm discouraged, I'll remind my soul of all you've done.
See, some people will catch what I'm saying, others won't.
Be distracted, even when I'm distraction. I will trust the one who is greater than the storm. I will trust the one who is greater than the storm.
Yeah. is, what happens too often is we quit praising. We get comfortable, so we stop praising. But see, I need for you to stop praying. I need for you to start praising. I need for you to realize that we don't ever stop praising God. I need for you to realize we don't ever stop worshiping God. Somebody, the battle is won. We have victory in the name of Jesus. We have who? We have victory. Now listen. I gotta play this. Because there was a reason why I did what I did. Because see, the Bible says for we do not fight against flesh and blood enemies, but against evil rulers and principalities in the unseen realm. My battle is not with the person. My battle is in the spirit behind the person. And the Bible says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but for they are mighty before God for the pulling down of strongholds. See, there is only some kind of fights that can only be won when you're in the spirit. See, when you're fighting, when you understand what you're fighting, you understand you need to fight differently. If I start going off on you, that's gonna be the flesh. If I start getting blow for blow and going all these things with you, that's the flesh. But when I begin to speak the name of Jesus, I get into the spirit. And I knew what I was fighting. It was not the person. It was the spirit behind the person. And the only way to be victorious in the manner that I am trying, that I need to be victorious, is for me to begin to fight in a different level. Because they're fighting here, but I need to fight on a place where I know, because I know a name that's already gotten victory. See, I don't have to. There are times to block, but I didn't need to block that. You know why? Because it is a test for me just as much as is. It's something that God, it needs to be taken care of. So now, let's just go ahead and praise God for the victory.
Angels are in this room.
Oh God, take us. God is about to unlock your spiritual eyes. God is unlocking your spiritual eyes. And we rise up and they will sing for you. You're worthy of it all. Unashamed, won't compromise. For from you are all things. Rababasa, Rababakerabasi. Rababasa, Tarabalabrasi, Rababasi, Karababa. Rimbabasi, Lebraki, Debasurababa. Rababasura, Babaseta, Rabake, Debaso. Rinka, Dabase, Debrabaseta, Rababo. Rimbabase, Lebrake, Debako. Ha, Rabako, Rabasi. Rambabasuramba shekarabasi, Urambaba kede basurambake, Rambabasuramba kede basurambake, Rambasikarabasata, Rindabasurambabasite rabasi, Rimbabasata, Rinkusuturamba shekarabasi, Rambabusurambaba, Rinkadabasurambake, Rasete de basurambake, Arambake de basurambaki. Oh God, I thank you, God. I thank you, God. I thank you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh God, I thank you, God. Oh, Rambabase de Barobase de Rabaso. Rinde de Basse Rabake. Rambabase de Baraba de Rabaso Rabaka. Rimbase de Bashe de Braso de Bara. Rimbabase de Bako Rambaba. Rambake de Basete Rabara, Rimbabasata, Rinderibara, Rumbabasara Bakurambasi. It's like I feel a wind. There's a wind in my lap. It's like a cold chill in my lap.
It's shifting the atmosphere.
to get delivered. Because I literally, the Lord is ministering to me that He is that He is about to deliver different people. And I just see people getting delivered from demonic oppressions. And many of you have been going through just, you've been influenced by demonic oppressions. Oh, my people, do you not see that I am in the room? My people, for I am here. Even many of you shall I expose myself to. For you not, shall not see her, but you shall see me, says the Lord. For I shall cause you to not see man, but I shall awaken your spiritual eyes to see me, says the Lord. I am getting ready to reveal myself. Prepare yourself to see angels. Prepare your eyes to see me, says the Lord. For you only think that you can see me in death, but there are many who saw me in life. For I shall cause you to see things you've never seen. Many of you, I have been calling you here. For I know my daughter does not look like what you're accustomed to. For I know my daughter does not look like what you've seen. But do not trust Takiya, but trust me, says the Lord. For it is not the man that you see, for it is me, says the Lord. It is my glory. It is my power. For it is not Takiya's power, for it is my power, says the Lord. For she is merely a vessel that I get my glory through. But for it is Jesus who you see standing here. For if you would look in the spirit, don't look in your flesh, but close your eyes and look again. Because if you would look again, you would see angels all around. For if you would look again, for it is your eyes. For the eye is the lamp of the body. For if your eye is full of light, for you shall see light. For angels are of the light. For angels are products of the light. But if your eye is not full of light, then it shall be difficult for you to see. For if you want to see things beyond your imagination, for you must get the light in you. For today, even as I speak through her, I am bringing light that you need to see as I shall cause you to see. So close your eyes, my people, for I shall lay my hands upon you, for I shall bring about your spiritual eyes to be awakened and be opened. Do not look in the flesh, but I shall cause you to see in the spirit. And when I tell you to open your eyes, then shall you open your eyes. But I want you to be obedient to me, says the Lord, for I am about to do something that many of you have never seen done before. Even as she blows, do you not understand? For it is not Takiya's voice. For it is not Takiya's breath. For there is no power in her breath, but there's power in my breath. Oh, shall you see the Ruach come forth? Oh, shall you see my breath be breathed? Many of you shall experience things you've never seen before. For I am pouring out my spirit in uncommon places. For I am removing anything that is a hindrance. For I am removing the restraints. God says, I am cutting it off today. I am cutting off everything that is hindering you today. For it is time. It is time. Now open your eyes and you shall see things you've never seen before, says the Lord. Oh, Rambabasata. Open your eyes, says the Lord. Rambabaso to Rambaba. Rambabaso Rambaba. Rinda dabaso dondarabara. Rimbabase de debaso to Rambaba. Rumboboso to Rambaba. Rinka selimbraco de base de barobaba. Rambabase te Rambaba. Rumboboso Rambaba. Rimbabase te de babo Rambaba. Rumboboso Rambaba. Rumboboso Rambaba se te rabaki. Harababa shake rababasa.
Spirit.
do something because many of you think that the only reason why you feel the spirit is because of a song. Let's take this song out of the way. And I'm just going to breathe over you. But see, I need for you to know that when I breathe, it's not Takiya breathing, it's the Ruah. And when I breathe over you, some of you, and some people said they can't even hear the music. Some people can't even hear the music that's going on. Lakita, I want you to let me know if you saw in the spirit. Lakita said she saw one on my shoulder. Anybody else see in the spirit today for the first time? Is this your first time ever seeing in the spirit? And let me know what you saw. When you saw in the spirit, what did you see? See, I know Jesus is standing right beside me. Even no, actually, he just moved behind me. I know Jesus is behind me. And I know there are angels everywhere. And I need you to understand that. And I know that many of you, this is your first time ever being on my live. And I know many of you, this is your first time ever being here. If it's your first time ever being here and ever experiencing anything like this, say me. But I know there's many people who are this their first time being here. Naisha saw an angel on my shoulder, on the side where your hair hangs longer. Harabase, somebody said, it's not my first time seeing in the spirit, but I know there are angels all around you. Somebody said, I started speaking in tongues, but it was a different dimension. So listen, I'm going to begin to blow. See, here's what's about to happen. When I blow, not only are you going to feel something, but I want for you to look at your curtains. And the Lord is telling me, look at the curtains in your house. And you're going to even begin, some of you will see even your curtains begin to blow. Even like I went up and you're going to see God move your curtains because I need for you to know the God of miracles. And I'm doing this to demonstrate the power of God, that God is a God of miracles. So I'm going to begin to blow. And I want you to look at your curtains. Because you're not good. This is Takiya's power. Takiya has left the room. Takiya, she's out of her mind. I don't even know where she's at right now. This we in dimensions right now. We in the spirit. Somebody said, I see fog behind you and an angel on your right shoulder. Come on. I felt the spirit blow on me. It was like the AC hit me. I've seen the image of God blowing over you before. It brought tears to my eyes. Even a blanket, but you're going to see things move in your house. Because I need for you to understand the spirit. The spirit. So as I blow, I need for you to understand that the spirit is moving. Thank you, Jesus. Anybody, did your curtains move? Because I need for you to know the God of miracles. We're already out of our mind. We're already in a reckless place. Somebody said, my blinds just moved. Somebody said their blinds moved. Somebody said, I felt wind. Go ahead and testify. Rambaba shika rababa sotu rambaba. Rambaba sete reba so rambaba. Somebody said theirs is moving. Somebody else's stuff moved too. We don't fake miracles around here. I don't gotta fake nothing around here. Because I know God is a God of miracles. Somebody said they saw, Diane saw her blinds move. Kyra saw her blinds move. Somebody said the wind. Somebody felt wind and chills. Somebody said, I felt wind. Somebody said their blinds are moving. Somebody said, I felt the old wind. Somebody said my blinds and my mat and the mask even under it was moving. Somebody said the door at work opened and the paper started blowing. God, somebody said the paper started blowing off their desk. My right arm felt the chill and I'm sitting under the heat. Somebody said I felt it in my hand. Somebody said I'm in my delivery van so I can't see nothing. It's okay, Becca. Somebody said their blinds is moving. Somebody said chills all over my body. Somebody said it blew on my hand this time. See, you can't fake this. Somebody said they felt a breeze. Harabasete de dabasoto rababa. Rambabaseka da dabasoto rabake. From the right side. Come on, somebody said I have chills. Talisha. Hey, Talisha. See, you cannot fake this. God is real. Arabasete ba. Somebody said the air conditioner is under the curtain in front of me, but my spine had a gust of wind on it. Somebody said, I felt it in my spirit. Somebody said, chills. Vanessa has chills. Somebody said, I felt it in my hand. And when I went to adjust my phone, you blew. Rababa sete daba kosh. Prophetess Chappelle. Hey, Prophetess Chappelle said her right hand was shaking. God is real. God is real. The Lord is beginning to show me that some of you are about to get miracle money in your accounts. Because I literally just saw money moved in the spirit. Somebody said the strings on my blinds are moving. I felt chills and start feeling chills. I just saw that money just moved in the spirit. And I just saw literally money moved in the spirit into your account. God, right now, I prophesy miracle money right now, God. And God, I thank you, Father God, that money just hit their account in Jesus' name. And even tax returns right now, God, I say the tax returns just was released to their accounts right now in Jesus' mighty name. Listen, testify, testify. If it happens for you, testify. God, I thank you right now, Lord. Credit scores. I want to speak over credit scores right now. I feel that in the spirit. God, right now, I prophesy to their credit score right now, Father God. And God, I say right now, their credit score just went up. Even some of you, 100 points. God, I thank you, Jesus, God, that their credit scores are going up right now in Jesus' name. Even the emails. God, right now, God, I say that their emails, God. I just saw some of you getting an email saying that you got approved. Oh, God, I thank you right now for shifting that right now, God. Somebody here is waiting on a visa. You just got approved in the spirit. I saw it. Rambaba sete de baso ramba ke. Rambaba sheka rababa sotu rababa. Rombo suramba ke. V, hallelujah. V, I see you in the spirit screaming. I just see you shouting in the spirit. Thank you, God. Now listen, don't just say it. Go check it, baby. Have faith. It's happening for you. It's happening for you. It's happening for you. Magdalena, God says, stop worrying. It's already taking place in the spirit. Hallelujah, Jesus. We thank you, Father God. Somebody said, Jesus, I was just approved for a business credit card. My credit score just went up 13 points. I was waiting on an approval for a loan. God, I thank you, God. Somebody said, I was struck with the flesh eating something, but I am now healed. God, right now, I speak over Prophetess Chappelle right now, God. God, and I say every single person who has tried to put any demonic oppression over her life, any demonic thing over her life, God, I literally sever that thing in the spirit right now. God, help Whitney, God. Help her, God. Oh, God, I thank you, Jesus, God. God, I speak right now over Kamu, God. Forgive me, Kamu. And God, I speak right now, God, that those lumps in their neck is going down right now, Father God. God, your word says that by your stripes we were healed. God, I speak right now over everybody, God, with a diagnosis that is contrary to you, God. God, I say right now they are healed in the mighty name of Jesus, God. Robo surabake de basata rabako rambase. Rembabaka da basurabake de basurabake. Rambabase telebrako de bosurabaki. God, right now, there's somebody here with fluid in your left knee. God, I speak right now into that left knee, God. And God, I say right now, you are healed in the mighty name of Jesus, that the fluid is leaving your knee right now in Jesus' name. God, right now, somebody has been having trouble with their spine. I see like you've been having this pain, especially it feels like needles or like a knife is being driven in the middle of your spine. God, I speak right now to their spine, God. And I say, be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we thank you, Father God. Oh, Rabba Sete de Basso Rambaba. Rinka se de Baroba Basheka Rabasi. Rimbaba Soko Rambake. Somebody said, I was led to this live and got an instant breakthrough. God, I thank you. Look at God. Somebody said they was led here and got an instant breakthrough. Just testify. Whenever you get your miracle, just go ahead and testify. Don't wait. Just go ahead and testify. There's somebody here, you've been dealing with migraines. I see migraines in the spirit right now, God. I speak over everybody under the sound of my voice, Father God, that's been dealing with migraines, God. God, I say be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, I thank you, Father God. I just literally see that migraine just left you. Like I just see like a peace just washing over your mind, Father God. God, we thank you, Jesus, God. Oh God, I thank you, Lord. God, I thank you, Jesus, God. God, there are many here praying for a sign, God. Oh God, I pray that you would help their unbelief, Father God. Oh Rabasheka Rabasi da Barobo Boso Rambake. Rambabaseka Labraso to Rambaba. Rombobo Shuku Rambasi. See, we pray for signs because we don't believe the word of God. We pray for signs because we don't believe or really know that God is doing it. So then God has to give signs and wonders because of our unbelief. See, God uses signs and wonders to build your faith because many people have a trouble just believing God and taking him at his word. So then God then ushers in a system. Do you understand that signs are the mercy of God? It is the mercy of God. See, I pray that you would get beyond always needing a miracle. Somebody said, somebody just got a miracle. I didn't have the money to pay the rent, but it shows it's paid already. Come on, is that miracle money? Is that miracle money? Somebody said, I didn't have the money to pay my rent, but it shows that it's already paid. Come on, God. See, many people are living from miracle to miracle. The Bible says we go from faith to faith and glory to glory. They said, I remembered you prayed for me. It was Sunday. Oh, I remember. I remember on Sunday, somebody said my headache is lifting up. See, listen. On Sunday, I had released the word over my people and I said, listen, I said, God is going to be paying your bills and you're not even going to have to pay for them at all because my spiritual father gave that word. And so I stand under the grace of my spiritual father and I spoke that word that he told us was going to happen. And look at God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. See, we pray for signs because we don't believe that. We don't trust God fully because when you trust God fully, you don't need a sign. His word is the sign. What are signs? Just words. You see these words. See, God is the only sign that I need. Can I pray that you get to the point where Jesus is the only sign you will ever need? Jesus had performed all these miracles, right? And they said, hey, if you would just give us a sign, if you would just show us, if you would just do this miracle, this sign, he said, then they will believe. And then Jesus told him, he said, no, they won't believe. He said, because they didn't even believe after Abraham. They didn't believe after all these things that took in place. So I'm not doing anything else because it had already been done. See, I want you to get to the point where you no longer are praying for a miracle anymore. Laura said her stocks went up. Come on. Listen, you had to, in my Wealth Builders Masterclass, right? In my Wealth Builders Masterclass, I told everybody to go buy stocks. Because God told me, listen, I'm not just a prophet, but I'm a prophetic business strategist as well. And Laura said her stocks went up. Come on, Jesus. Come on, Jesus. That we can speak to your... Look, my stocks just went up too. Come on, God. Our stocks just went up. Come on, God. Come on, our stocks just went up. Everybody that I told you to buy that stock that I told you to buy, go check it. Did you buy yours last night, Jordan? Our stocks just went up. Come on, God. Come on, God, that our stocks just went up. Oh, thank you, Father God. Oh, God, I thank you, Jesus. It's in my, you'd have to get in my class. It was in my Well Builders Masterclass. I told all my people that's in my program. I said, go buy these stocks. And our stocks just went up. Somebody said, Erica said, I haven't paid our gas or water bill for the past 3 months because there was a miracle credit to our account. Erica Hill. Erica, can I ask you a question? Can I ask you a question? I didn't have money until today to buy what I want. Well, go buy because they're up. Erica, before you came into the ministry, had you ever heard of miracle money like that? That God did miracle money like that? Hey, Danielle. God, we thank you. We know that God gives blessing, but I'm talking about where money just be hidden accounts and that don't make no sense. Because God, when I tell y'all, has anybody, everybody go check your, go check. How we gonna, you gotta go check. Go check your credit. Go check your, go check. Go, you gotta go check. Because God, now listen, the only, this, Erica said, I never had heard of it. It was God. And I'm not having Erica to testify this because I want to say like, oh, Takiya, do this. No, I want you to understand the dimensions of God. Because some of you only think that God can do this one thing. Listen, God will cause that thing to come down to your budget. You don't need the money for the car. You just need for God to bring that car down to your budget. Can I prophesy over your life that God is bringing those things which you desire down to your budget? God is doing miracles. God is doing miracles in this room. God, I thank you, God, for miracles. Thank you, God, for miracles. Oh, Rabba Sheka, Rabba Sata, Rambaba. Erica said, God has done miracles in our finances. Erica, how many streams? I remember because I gave Erica and Steve a prophetic word that God was going to give them X amount of streams of income. And Erica and them checked and they now have that amount of streams of income. How many is it, Erica? Because I want you to see God. I want you to see God. I want you to see how God works. 5 streams of income. They now have 5 streams of income. They now have 5 streams of income. Come on, God. Come on, see, God is faithful. God is faithful. And she said, and we have all 5 coming in. Come on. Thank you, God, that all. What did he say? I want to read something. How do you fully trust God? You surrender to his word and you take his word as truth. You take God's word as truth in your life. And you don't doubt it. And Steve got promoted to working directly under the president of the company. And Steve got promoted and he's working directly under the president of the company. I wouldn't be shocked if one day he becomes the president of the country, the company, huh? Come on. Come on. I want to read you something. God says, behold, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it and know it? And will you not give heed to it? He says, I've already done my wealth builders masterclass. Somebody said my credit went up 25 points and all their hard inquiries are gone. Come on. You can, I don't even, we haven't even. So my Wealth Builders replay is $75. So email me if you want the replay for it, y'all. But listen, email me if you want the replay for it, and I'll send you the link for it. But listen, I got to tell you something. Somebody just said my credit score went up 25 points. All hard inquiries are gone. They said all hard inquiries are gone. Gone. They're gone. They're gone. Come on, somebody. Can I say it again? They're gone. They no longer exist. Can I just go ahead and speak that all the things on your, somebody, can I just speak over all your stuff and say it's gone? It don't even exist. The same God who did it for her is doing it for you. Now, notice what the word says. It says, because I give waters in the wilderness. Notice what God says. I give waters. God didn't say I give water. He said I give waters. He says I give waters. Is anybody catching the word yet? I just want to know. Is anybody catching the word yet? God says I give waters in the wilderness. Then God says, and I give rivers in the desert. See, listen. Your financial situation was a desert, wasn't it? But I speak that God is giving rivers in your desert. See, your financial situation was a desert, but I speak that God is creating multiple. Notice he said rivers. Erica, God said rivers. He didn't just say a river. He said rivers. He didn't just say water. He said waters. Sounds like streams to me, don't it? Sounds like streams to me, don't it? Is anybody catching these streams today? Is anybody catching these streams today? So, thank you, God. Somebody said, I want to take your class, but I'm struggling with bills right now. Well, I just say that God is turning that around. God is turning that around. God is turning that around. God, I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus, God. Lord, I prophesy right now, God, that miracles are released right now in Jesus' name. God, I thank you that the miracles are released right now in Jesus' mighty name. God, I thank you, Lord, for the turnaround. Can I just go ahead and prophesy a turnaround in your life? That God is turning everything around. Can I read this scripture to you? I want to read a scripture to you. Proverbs 8:18. I want to declare the word of God over you. And as I begin to declare the word of God, I want you to go ahead and, now listen, I don't want you to ask yourself this question. I don't want you to ask yourself this question. I want you to ask God this question. We're getting ready for the greatest time. But see, this is what I need you to know about my room that's different than anybody's room. In the room that you're in today, we're a room of givers. We give. We don't play when it comes to giving. Not only do we give, though, we also give for others. So I don't want you to leave just because you don't have a seed. We have people here who will sow a seed for you. But see, listen, we're getting ready to go into offering time pretty soon, y'all. And as we get ready to go into offering time, I want you to go ahead and begin to ask God, God, what do you want me to do? Say, God, what do you, I don't want to know what you want to do. I want to know what God said. I will prophetess, I only have this. What does God say? Because if you keep giving out of, you got to get out of the mindset. Because some of you sow out of a poverty and a lack mindset. Don't sow out of your poverty, but sow out of your prosperity. How do I sow out of my prosperity? Because if I don't have prosperity, but God has prosperity, then I know that I need to be asking God what he wants me to do. Because when I'm sowing out of the prosperity, then I'm going to reap out of the prosperity. Sow from a different place today. Don't sow from a place of lack, but sow from a place of abundance. So say, God, what do you want me to do today? So as I'm reading scriptures, I want you to start praying. I'm not going to tell you what to give. I'm going to tell you to ask God what he's telling you to give. So when God puts something in your heart, just be obedient to do what God told you to do. So let me read something to you, okay? Proverbs 8:18. It says, riches and honor are with me. It says, riches and honor are with me. Enduring wealth and righteousness, uprightness in every area, and relation and right standing with God. God says, riches and honor are with him. Thank you, God. God says, riches. I want to read this. Then it says, my fruit is better than gold. Yes, than refined gold. And my increase better, my increase than choice silver. It says, I wisdom walk in the way of righteousness, moral and spiritual rectitude in every area and relationship, in the midst of the path of justice, that I may cause those who love me to inherit true riches. Then when you fall in love with wisdom, it says, I will cause you to inherit true riches, that I may fill their treasures. Notice that. He says, I will fill their treasures. Deuteronomy 8:18 says, thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he who empowers you to get wealth. Let's read some scriptures on this, y'all. Proverbs 8:18. No, let's read Proverbs chapter 10, verse 22. Because what I'm doing is I'm flooding light into you. Before you go, before we give and we do our tithes and our offerings, I want to flood light into you. So that way when you start to give, so much light has come into you that when you sow, you're sowing because light has, so much light has come into you. Proverbs 10 verse 22 says, the blessing of the Lord, it makes truly rich, and he adds no sorrow with it, neither does toiling increase it. Come on, he says, neither does toiling increase it. I don't gotta toil when I got God. Somebody say, I don't gotta toil when I got God. The Bible says, Proverbs chapter 11, somebody said, my hands lifted and started shaking like angel wings. Come on, God. God is, do you think that we're out of the spirit because we're in offering time? No. Offering time is one of the most spiritual times there is. We're still in the spirit, y'all. We're still flowing. Proverbs chapter 11, verse 24 says, there are those who generously scatter abroad. He says, there are those who generously scatter abroad. Oh, may you be those who generously scatter abroad. God, I will be named among those who generously scatter abroad. It said, and yet increase more. God says, when you give, when you generously give, he said, you will increase more. So society tells me that I save in order to get more, but God says I give in order to get more. If you want to receive more, if you want to increase more, you got to release. Look, people already giving for each other, and I ain't even put up the giving information. Come on, Shay is giving for Rachel today. Come on. It says, there are those who withhold. Come on. Those of you that withhold, let me tell you what happens. It says, but there are those who withhold more than is fitting and what is due justly, but they only result in want. What if the reason why can I go ahead and tell you something? You will always sit in want until you learn how to give to God. I'm not even going to sugarcoat it today. I'm past that version of Takiya. I'm just going to call it how it is. As long as you are sitting over there and not being obedient to what God is telling you to do, you will never have what God wants for you to have. Because listen, I just got to go there today. Because I just got to be obedient to God today. Because you think that by not giving, you're saving yourself. But by not giving, you're actually destroying your own self. Because the demon of poverty can only be conquered through our giving. So if you don't give, then you give the demon of poverty access to your life. Let's go to the scripture. Malachi chapter 3, the passage in which everybody likes to say is only in the Old Testament. The place where they only say there. Mm-mm. Keep your wig on, Najwa. And listen, some of you wait to verse 8. I'm not waiting to verse 8. I want to read before verse 8 so you can get something to understand. Malachi verse 3, starting at verse 6. Let's go there together. Let's go to Malachi chapter 3, but don't start at verse 8. I want you to start at verse 6 because many people start at verse 8. I'm starting at verse 6 because we're going to break something out today and we're going to deal with it. And listen, if you get offended by this, ask God. If this bothers you, go to God. Malachi chapter 3, verse 6. For I am the Lord, I do not change. Malachi, you feel me tugging on your wig, don't you already, Najwa? I'm tugging at your wig. Malachi chapter 3, verse 6. For I am the Lord, I do not change. That is why you, O sons of Jacob, are not consumed. He says the reason why we ain't consumed is because he is a good father. He's a good father. And I'm gonna, y'all don't understand. This is really wildly outside of my comfort zone. It says, even from the days of your father, you have turned aside from my ordinances and have not kept them. He says, return to me and I will return to you. It says, but you say, how shall we return? How shall we return? See, Bray, people sowing for you. God says, how shall you return? How do I return to you? It says, will a man rob or defraud God? Yet you rob and defraud me. But you say, in what way do we rob or defraud you? You have withheld your tithes and your offerings. Now, many of you, because I'm bold. I'm just going to call it how it is today. Many of you take that right now and the enemy just put this in your mind. Let me just go ahead and just talk about your mind for a moment. When I read that scripture, because I am a pastor and I'm a prophetess. When I read that scripture, the enemy just told you that she only is saying that because she wants your money. She's only saying that because she wants your money, correct? Yeah. She's one of them TikTok preachers who's just only about your money. Mm-hmm. I hear you. Let me tell you something. Underneath every lie, there is a truth hidden. When the devil starts to lie to you, there is a truth hidden. Let me ask you a question. The devil is telling you that, correct, right? And when the devil starts telling you that, I just want to know, 9 times out of 10, who does the devil tell that to? Is the devil telling that to somebody who is living in an overflow situation? Or does he tend to only speak that to people who are struggling month to month? Y'all, we got somebody from Greece here. The enemy speaks that because the demon of poverty knows that the only way that you can defeat him is through your giving. So the enemy will get you to stop giving because he knows that if I can get you to stop giving, I can get you broke. Now, I have been broke. Thank God that's a part of my past. The devil don't tell that to people who are wealthy as much. Notice that. He tells it to people. And do you ever notice that the enemy? Can I ask y'all a question? Let's deal with the devil real quick. Because I need for you to see your devil for who. You the richest lady on earth. I receive it, Prophet White. I receive it. You ever notice that when it's time to start doing offering, the enemy starts reminding you of all your bills you got to pay? You ain't thought about your bills this whole time, but all of a sudden you're thinking about it now. You ever notice that all of a sudden when it's time to give, you it's time for you to sow a seed, the devil starts bringing up all the things you got to pay. You ain't thought about them bills. You never think about them bills, but now you think about them bills. That card note ain't even been a topic of discussion until now. You ain't thought about anything, but the devil brings it up now. Why? Because the devil wants you to live month to month. He loves it. I don't even know how a personal account can be negative $27,025.71. That is interesting. I didn't know an account could be that. Here's the thing. If you put it in my comments, I just may address it and stuff. So when y'all put stuff in the comments, just be mindful that everybody sees that, you know, and stuff. Jessica sold $20 for whoever needs it. Jessica, can that one of those be for that lady who put in the comments and said that she don't have the money to sew? The lady with the bank account, can that be for her? But listen, notice how the enemy starts working in your mind. Laura is sewing for Bray. Thank you, Jess. Jess is in my mentorship program. She's in my sis tribe. Thank you so much. Irene just sewed for 6 people. But notice that. And I ain't showed you the information yet. Love you. Love you, Jess. I ain't done it yet because I need to deal with some things today. Because I need for you to get beyond the devil beating you up. Every time you sit there in your mind, because I got to deal with it today. Every time you sit there in your mind and you're like, she's just doing that because she wants my money. You just blocked your own miracle. I don't need your money. Keep it. Keep it. Please. That's fine with me. Because I don't need your money to prophesy over you. If you think for 1 second that your money is even equivalent to the hell I've went through for this gifting, you got the wrong person. If that's what you think about me, keep it. It's okay. Because the enemy is trying to come in and bring in these lies, and you got to make a decision. Are you going to take the bait, or are you going to say, nah, I'm not taking that bait today? Don't take the bait of the devil. Look. That's Teal. Teal is sewing $100 for people. I want to deal with that today. Because so many people, you're so caught up in your pastor. And all you're caught up is in that person. And you're looking at that person and you're saying, they just want something from me. I ain't never heard a wealthy person say that. Maybe y'all have, but I've never heard a wealthy person say that. Why? Because do you realize that wealthy people are always looking to invest? If I'm going to invest, baby, I'm investing in the kingdom. And so many times, we got to get rid of that mentality. Stop looking at people and look at yourself. You got to deal with your own house. And you got to, because that is something between you and God. And God is wanting to move you to another dimension. But God cannot move you. Yeah. God can't move you to another dimension as long as you're looking at somebody else. So let's get back to the word. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Did it just go up some more? Okay, God. So he says, you have withheld your tithe and offering. He says, you are cursed with a curse, for you are robbing me, even this whole nation. It's not. So he said, you are cursed with a curse. So he said, it's already, the reason why you don't do it is because of a curse. It's not a matter that God is cursing you because you ain't tithing. It's a matter that it's already on you. And that's what's keeping you from tithing. The enemy has already entered into you. So because the enemy has already entered into you in that area of your life, that's what's keeping you from doing. It's not a matter of I am cursed because I'm not tithing. It's not a matter that God is putting a curse on me because I don't tithe. It's a matter that a curse is already upon you, which is why you don't do it. God is saying the reason why you don't do it is because of a curse. And you got to break that demon of poverty out for you. You got to break that curse because it's because of something that's on you that's causing you to not be able to do it. If you didn't have a curse on you in your financial situation, would you think twice to give or so? No. So you don't tithe or give because there's something on you that's keeping you from doing it. So I'm trying to tell you why you're not able to do it. If you are a touchy and a fretful person, see, this is the thing. We as the body of Christ have got to get to where we stop getting so offended about everything. We got to grow up, and you don't want nobody to tell you. The reality is a lot of times we don't want nobody to tell us why don't I have money to sow? If the Bible says the blessing of the Lord makes you rich, if we know that the blessing will cause there to be more than enough in your life, right? The Bible says the blessing of the Lord will give you a surplus of prosperity. What does the word surplus mean? The word surplus means, and vow, you actually don't even start giving offering and tithe. So technically, you're still tithing. But listen, because I want to teach on this for a moment because I don't want you to give this I don't want you to do this out of a place of not knowing. I want to flood light into that area. So as I'm flooding light into this area, okay? So going back to scripture. So the blessing will cause you to have a surplus of prosperity. And that surplus of prosperity, correct, means that there is enough that even after you paid all your bills, there's more than enough left over. So we know that the blessing will make it where you have enough left over, more than enough left over, right? You said that and the door opened up again. Come on. But then we know that if there's a curse there, right? If there's a curse there, then God says that he broke off the curse. But the curse has poverty. The curse has lack. And I'm trying to tell you why you don't have the money to give. Because there's something in your life. It's not, there's something in your life that is keeping you from getting to the point. And I'm telling you this because it has to come a point in time where we have got to be willing to know why. Nobody wants to know why they can't sow. Nobody wants to know why they can't give. It's simple. The Bible says, I've given you spiritual shepherds after my heart to give you knowledge. I want to give you knowledge. I don't just want to sit up here because being honest with you, I have to sit here and read every last one of your comments. And when you tell me you can't give, you don't have the money to sow. And it breaks my heart. I hate seeing that. Not from a rude standpoint, but from a standpoint of it irritates me that the devil is keeping God's people. Listen, the devil is keeping God's people from being able to do what God has called all of us to do. Because the enemy gets into your mind. And the enemy gets into your mind and you have this poverty mindset. And because of the enemy working in your mind, it's making you not be able to do what God has called you to do. And it's keeping you from being able to do what God has called you to do. But today is the day that thing breaks. That poverty mentality breaks today. And we got to get our houses in order. And the only way to get our houses in order is with the word of God. So track with me and I'm going to read this to you, okay? So God says, bring all the tithes, the whole tenth of your income into the storehouse. So God says, give me, listen, I need for y'all to pay attention and I need for y'all to listen, okay? Right now, I am educating. I want to give y'all the word before we give. So wait. There's a reason why I'm telling you to wait. I know you want me to turn this camera around. I know you itching to give, and I'm so glad that you're itching to give because you need to have that heart. But listen, I need for you to focus. Because I need to flood light into this area. I need to bring the word of God into this area of your life, okay? So that way when you give, you're coupling the word of God with it, okay? So I'm thankful you want to give. I really am. But I really want you to just focus, okay? Focus, y'all. So he says, the whole tenth of your income into the storehouse so that there may be food in my house. Improve me now by it, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the windows of heaven for you and pour you out a blessing that there shall be enough, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. Now, let me ask you a question, because we're going to do a little question so we can get this all together. He says, what opens up the windows of heaven? He says, of hosts, that I will not open the windows of heaven for you and pour you out a blessing that there shall not be enough room to receive it. What opens the windows of heaven? Tell me in the comments. Not just tithing. It's not just giving. It's not faith, not just faith. It is, faith is a component. It's not just tithing. It's tithing and offering. It's both of them together. He says, bring your tithes into the storehouse. But he told them prior they were robbing him with their tithes and offerings. So it's when we bring this to God and we bring it in faith. Do you know it takes faith to give God your money? It takes faith. Quiet time, don't do it. Mm-mm. He says, when you do this, see that I will not open the windows of heaven for you and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be enough room to receive it. Now, let's go over to my favorite passage. Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 9. Okay? 2 Corinthians chapter 9. It says, remember, this is why I brought it necessary to urge these brethren to go to you before I do. And make arrangements in advance as I do. And make it for this bountiful promise gift of yours. Then I'm going to get to that. Give me just a moment. We've already talked about giving, right? We talked about tithes and offerings. Now we're about to deal with the heart behind it, okay? We got to deal with the motive. Because there has to be a motivation. So we're going to deal with the motivation now, okay? It says, remember this. He who sows sparingly and grudgingly will reach. Tithing is 10% of your income. Offering is like a seed. So it says, he who sows sparingly and grudgingly will reap sparingly and grudgingly. And he who sows generously, notice this. I just caught it. Oh my goodness. I never knew that. God just downloaded. Oh my. Wow. Okay, I gotta read this. And I don't know if y'all caught it, but I just caught it. Oh, I just caught it, God. God is speaking to me right now. Give me just a second. God just downloaded stuff to me. Okay. I got to read this. And I just want to, I got to read this. God just downloaded something to me. It says, he who sows sparingly and grudgingly will also reap sparingly and grudgingly. Right? Okay. But hear this. And he who sows generously. The word generously right there, this is what it means. It says, he who sows generously that blessings may come to someone will also reap generously and with blessings. Now, let me tell you what the Lord just said to me. He said, Takiya, the one who only sows for themselves, they are sowing sparingly and grudgingly. He says, but when you get beyond just sowing for yourselves, so it's not that when you, because when you're sowing sparingly and grudgingly, you're still reaping, but you're only reaping sparingly and grudgingly. So you're only reaping enough for just you, enough to just take care of you. But then it says, but he who sows generously, that blessings may come to someone else. He said, will also reap generously and with blessings. So God says, when you start sowing, not just for you, but you start sowing for other people. When you get to the point where you start sowing for other people, you have then graduated to where you now are considered to God a generous giver. Maybe some of you already knew that, but I didn't know that. Then the Lord began to take me over to Genesis, right? The Lord began to take me over to Genesis. He said, Takiya, notice something about Abraham. I want you to notice something about Abraham. God told Abraham, I will make of you a great nation. Now, for God to make of you a great nation, you would need to have a lot. I mean, you would need to have a lot. Baby, I need you to stay because I need for you to catch this revelation God just gave me, okay? Okay. So, y'all, I got to repeat because I got to give Elijah this revelation God just gave me, okay? Okay, so the Lord just gave me this revelation, okay? He says, and I want you to read it, and then I'm gonna break it down with the Lord. Tell me, okay, honey?
Okay.
He says, remember this, he who sows sparingly and grudgingly will also reap sparingly and grudgingly, right? Mm-hmm. But he said, and he who sows generously that blessings may come to someone else. Oh. When you give spirit, so God began to show me, he said, the one who only sows seed for himself, that's the sparingly and grudgingly giver. Because when I sow seed for myself, then I'm only sowing enough seed to take care of my house. Mm. But he said, notice how he said the generous giver is the one who sows for other people. So I'm kind of realizing that, baby, we got to graduate today. Because most seeds, I got to just be real about myself. Most seeds we're sowing, right, will be for our family.
Yeah.
But you got to start sowing for other people.
You know, it's like the difference between having a personal garden and having a field full of crops.
Eli said, it's like, I got to be real, DG Strength. Like, I've sowed for other people, don't get wrong, but like, I'm just like thinking though. Eli said, it's like the difference between having your own personal garden versus you having a field of a garden that can feed everybody else. Do you just want a personal garden or do you want a field that can feed other people too? Hmm. What if the greatest blessing we could give to our friends would not necessarily be to just give them that, but to actually sow a seed for them
on their account?
But get this, it says, it didn't, and if we're taking it a step further, I need y'all to go down this is what it's like when God downloads something for me, okay? Because we about to go down a well of wealth. Let track with me for a second, okay? Notice how the Bible says about the greatest thing you can do is lay down your life for somebody else. Mm-hmm. Okay, we know that our money, we work for money.
Time is money.
Money is time.
Wow, that's good.
And man. When you go to work, right, and you make $20 an hour, you just gave. So when I sow a seed of $20, I just sowed 1 hour of my life. Because that seed is worth 1 hour of my life. Come on. Are y'all correct with me? So God says that you can lay. So the greatest thing you can do is lay down your life for somebody else. I want to ask God, being real to y'all, when I sow a seed of $20, could that be like, when I sow a seed of $20 for my friend, right? Would that be like me giving up an hour of my life, God, for my friend, so that my friend may, I'm giving up an hour of my life so that way my friend can reap a harvest of blessing. That's just my thinking, you know, like that's just me just in God, right? Okay, now, the Lord began to tell me this, honey. Okay, remember? Okay, so the Lord says to Abraham, right? God told Abraham, I will make of you a great nation and I will bless you with abundant increase. So notice how God tells Abraham, he says that I'm going to make of you a great nation, correct? And in him making, so he didn't say he didn't tell Abraham, I'm going to bless your house. He said, I'm going to make nations out of you. Mm-hmm. So nations are to come out of him. Then he said, I'm going to bless you with abundant increase of favors, right? He said, I'm going to make your name famous in the street, distinguished. But one of the things that really the Lord said, he said, Takiya, notice how I told Abraham that Abraham was to be a blessing dispensing good to others. Mm-hmm. It wasn't that Abraham was called to just take care of Sarah and Isaac. Abraham was called to dispense good to others. So, but God, do you know how the Bible says that daily God loads us up with his benefits? You know what I said? How God, so notice how God says, I load you up daily. God doesn't just load us daily up just for us, but God wants to load us up so we can be a blessing to others. Because if I don't have gas in my tank to go, say, okay, let's say we were driving to a service that was going to be life-changing. If I don't have enough gas in my tank to drive myself to the service, how would I have enough gas in my, how would I be able to also drive five other people to that service that could potentially get that breakthrough? Mm. And the Lord is beginning to minister to me how God says, he who sows grudgingly and sparingly will not also reap, will you not reap grudgingly and sparingly? God is so merciful. God is so merciful that he could have made it where we don't reap nothing at all. But his mercy says that even though you may not be at the point where you can sow for somebody else, I'm still going to take care of you. Mm. It's just that if you want me to take care of you in a generous kind of way, you got to get beyond just taking care of you. Where you start learning how to sow and be a blessing to other people. Mm. So he says that he who sows generously is the one who sows that blessings may come to somebody else. So we're not even considered a generous giver until we start sowing to the point where it would benefit somebody else. Till we start sowing to the point. Because one thing I've often heard, you know, you and Angel say is, if you only just pray for you, but you pray for nobody else, that's not good. Then we should pray not just for ourselves. And then the Bible even tells us, even if we're talking about healing, right? In James chapter 5, verse 23. Mm-hmm. But in James chapter 5, verse 16 says, pray also for another that you may be healed and restored. So God say, if you want to get your healing, you got to be willing to pray that somebody else is willing to get healed. So that's why God says, love our neighbors as we love ourselves. Because God says, if you want it to be done in you, you got to do it for somebody else first. Whatever you sow, you will reap. So if I sow for somebody else and I pray for God to bless somebody else, then I'm going to reap that in my own life. Wow. I'm sowing a seed for somebody today.
So 5 seeds of 20.
Can I tell y'all something? Let me show you how in alignment we are in. Pastor Eli, I was just about to say I'm going to sow $100 for some people, right? Then Elijah tells me, sow 5 seeds of 20. You didn't even know I was going to sow a $100 seed.
I didn't.
Come on, God.
So let's have it right now. Those who can't sow right now, we want to sow on your behalf. So go, now's your chance to speak up in the comment section. Go ahead and say, that's me. We only can do it 5 people because this is what God is putting in our heart. Mm-hmm. And so we want to be obedient to that. So 5 people, If you can't sow for whatever reason, or you've already sowed, but you want that extra blessing, say, that's me.
Okay, I'm going to say the first five names. We're going to pick the first five.
First five names.
The first, so that's the easy way to do that.
I'm
okay.
Get a pen. All right.
I'm sowing for Tamika. Tamika.
Hold on. Let me.
The first five names. Tamika. Glamorous 522. I am adorned too.
You said I adorned?
Mm-hmm. Linda. And then Dragon Butterfly. Those are the first five names. Praise God. I'm going to sow it right now.
Do it.
Thank you, Father God. God is changing everything today.
I'll tell you what. As she's doing this.
What's the name of your seed?
Yes.
What's the name of your seed?
Name your seeds right now.
I need y'all five. I need to know what your name is or your seed is.
As she's doing this, I'm going to put a song and we're going to start praying, okay?
Okay, I just sowed for five people. Come on, God.
Oh, you're done?
Uh-huh. Somebody said, I want to sow a seed for someone. Oh, I got everybody about to sow for the people now. Okay, y'all. Y'all ready to give? Now that we have revelation, are y'all ready to give? Y'all ready to give now that we got revelation? Oops. We got to sow for five people. Y'all fight it. We sow for five people today. Come on. Perfect. Cashapp, you can sell by Chime, Venmo, PayPal, and Zelle. We do have a Zelle.
Here comes the glory.
Y'all ready to pray? Y'all ready to pray? Somebody said, yesterday my bank account was negative $1,500, but the Lord made a miracle and now I can sow a seed for me and someone else.
Wow, man.
Look at God. Hey, y'all, make sure y'all be checking for your miracles. I want to play this. Testimonies in the comments. I love you, Lakita. I love you, Lakita. Make sure y'all put your testimonies in the comments, okay, y'all? Declare some scriptures over you, okay? I'm gonna declare some scriptures over you. Lord God, I thank you right now that you put prosperity and welfare in each and every one of their homes, God. And God, that your righteousness, God, and you are giving, and that you shall give it to them which will endure forever, which is Psalms 112. I will show you another way to sew. Give me just a sec. Let me take care of that first. To the lady who wants to sew, I need for you to go to the link in the bio. If you have a computer, because I actually have a different way that you can sew. I just didn't put it on here. Because it's not the predominant way I use. Okay, here is another way that we have that you can sew. Give me just a moment. Because RM, I know you was one of the people that was like, now, I want to sew now. Okay, look. Now, this is another way you can sew, okay? Now, this takes different, this takes Apple Pay, Google Pay, all the kind of pays. So, go to my Linktr.ee, okay? Go to my Linktr.ee, which is dash Takiya Arevalo, okay? Then, click sew a seed here. This will then allow you to put in your card. You can put in your Apple Pay. You can put in any kind of card here. Somebody said, girl, I commented on your live this morning about a job offer, and I just got the offer letter.
Oh, wow.
What did you expect, Nicole? Miracles just happened. Come on. Lakita, don't make me cry. She does this. She said, I prayed for Amelia's healing, and I'm sowing a seed into it as well. She always gets me when she does that, man. So, yeah, so y'all can go here to my Linktr.ee, and you can sow a seed there. She always chokes me up because many of y'all... Why is she sowing a seed into Amelia? So you may be new here, but I have a healed and whole daughter, Amelia, who is in a wheelchair. We don't receive that in Jesus' name. But I have a daughter, my healed and whole daughter, who's currently in a wheelchair, but she's coming out of it, and she will walk, she will talk, she will run, and she will not grow weary. And I get so emotional when Lakita does this. And I got to say something, because Lakita, you don't know how many people I've come across in ministry, in my life. And there, you are a different person. Like, I do not explain it or the words I could say, but there's just like, you are a different breed. That's the word I would say. You are a different breed. There is just something different about you than anybody I have ever met, anybody I've had in my ministry. And I'm going to tell you the difference that is about you that I've noticed. Most people, and this is just the truth, this is people, okay? Most people come in to take, right? Most people come in to get something. And Lakita, what I love about Lakita is always giving. I want to say Lakita was one of the first people who actually started that movement of giving to other people and stuff. And she was a part of the beginning of when they were just giving to other people, you know, and stuff. And when I tell y'all, there's just something, you're just different, you know what I mean? And I just want to thank you just for so much. I just want to thank you because you are a breath of fresh air for me. And I'm not saying that everybody, I don't want y'all to perceive, I'm saying like all of y'all are here to get something from me. I don't know what y'all, you know what I mean? Like, that's between you and God. But I do know that I encounter more people that are here to get something from me than to give something. That's just the reality of it, you know? And stuff. And Lakita is just like, I remember when Lakita first did that, and she said, I'm sewing for your daughter Amelia. And I've never had somebody just sew for my daughter Amelia, who said, hey, I'm gonna sew a seed for your daughter Amelia. And then she told everybody needs to sew a seed for Amelia. And I remember all these people just started flooding me, just Amelia, 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 Amelia. Yeah, and it's like, the people aren't just standing with me. You're not just standing with me in the sense to say, okay, Takiya, I'm believing for Amelia's healing. No, you're saying, can we just be real? Money is one of the hardest things to give. Money is the hardest things to give. That's, it just is. And so one thing about Lakita, it's like, I see what she does for y'all, you know? I see all that, and just seeing how, you know, she would be willing. She don't just say, Takiya, I'm praying for Amelia. She says, I'm going to put my money towards sowing into Amelia. Somebody said, the last time you prayed for me, I received an answer the next day. I need that same kind of prayer. And it's like, it's just crazy, like, how y'all have sowed into my daughter. And I just want to say, like, you know, I don't take it lightly, and I truly thank y'all so much. And I just thank y'all. I thank everybody who gives to this ministry and things like that, because of your giving, like, it does allow me to. I preach 6 days a week. That's just that simple as it gets. Okay. I preach 6 days a week, you know, and things like that. And it just being able to preach 6 days a week. And most of those days I preach 2 times a day. I'm able to have an amazing mentorship program. I'm able to, you know, sow into different things and stuff like that. You know, don't think for 1 second I don't give. Oh, I. Some of y'all were on that live when we were watching Hubert Angel with me. And he says, Takiya Arevalo, da-da-da-da-da. Yeah. You know, and now, like, Elijah's here. And Elijah's, you know, able to give into the men and stuff like that. And, you know, we're able to preach the word of God. We're able to give back, you know. And things like that. So when someone sows a seed on your behalf, God then blesses you in whatever areas they're sowing a seed in and stuff like that, because we know it's seed that causes the harvest to come. And just being able to, you know, I'm getting ready to, God has really, really called me on my comfort zone. Okay. My comfort zone is preaching online. I can do online stuff. I'm tech savvy. It's like that, but I'm getting ready to travel. And so it allows me to travel and bring the word of God to wherever God calls me to, you know, being able to pour back into people, being able to, you know, do things at a low cost, being able to, because not only am I a pastor and I preach, but being honest, I also do coaching sessions. I also do, you know, I also coach. I do, you know, I own my own boutique and stuff like that. So we own Bougie's Boutique. Y'all know I'm a best-selling author, so I have multiple books and stuff like that. And we're able to, you know, I love y'all so much. And I'm able to, what's the word I was trying to say? But just being, I'm able to do master classes. And my master classes, can I be real with y'all? My master classes are designed for Christians. I don't do life coaching sessions, you know, for the world. I do it for Christians. That is the audience that really I help. I help Christians, you know, to be wealthy in their businesses. I help Christians to be wealthy in whatever area of life, you know. And me and Elijah, like, if you'd have just, and anybody who was just in my Wealth Builders Masterclass, they can tell you that Wealth Builders Masterclass we did, that we were able to do, me and Pastor Elijah was able to do, we gave so much. We're able to give so much value. We listen, y'all, we got, do you understand? We got Christian people over here investing in stocks. Two little kids who come, like me and Elijah come from poverty. We both come from being broke, all the stuff, you know? And even just Shay too, y'all. I'm so thankful for Shay. V's been with me since July. And there's so many people I can name. I can name Linda, and I can name Tamika, multiple Tamikas that we have. We have so many V's in our, we have more V's and Jess and all the different ladies. But, you know, we got Christian people investing in stocks. Like, that's what it's about. We're able to teach Christians, me and Elijah, we teach Christian families how to be wealthy. We teach Christian families how to invest in stocks and how to be wealthy. And we teach Christian people about real estate. We're getting our people beyond just buying a house for themselves. We're teaching people how to buy blocks. We're teaching people how to believe God to do all these amazing things. Why? Because God has blessed me and Pastor Elijah where can I tell you that my real estate business is used for the kingdom? How? In one of my real estate properties, we are letting pastors stay there for free. They don't charge, we don't charge a dime. They stay there for free every single month. And they're able to just be pastors and be who God has called them to be. They're able to travel and do whatever God has called them to do, but they have a house they can stay in. And I'm not saying all this to look at Takiya and Elijah. Don't look at me. Look at God. We're able to do this and able to not, I don't got to charge them nothing a month. Because of God and His grace and His mercy. And that is the blessing of the Lord, where we're able to help people and we're able to give to people and we're able to give back to the community, because that's what God has called us to do, y'all. And I'm so thankful to God for blessing us to be able to be a blessing. It's about being a blessing. In my business, you know, like in Bougie Sis Boutique, our whole apparel is about, is Christian apparel. Yeah, Yeah, Teal, I just got your email. But we're able to, for Christian families, and we're having women wearing their faith. Like, this is one of our shirts in Bougie's Boutique, and it says, God is going to display you in front of those who try to defeat you. That's what it's about. We wear our faith as a reminder of who God is in our life. It ain't just about I having a boutique, because being honest with y'all, I was like, God, I really am already busy, Lord. Like, if y'all knew my schedule is busy, is hectic. My schedule is so hectic because not only do I preach, I preach, yes, I do, but I also have a mentorship program. I also run a boutique. I also am a wife. I have 3 children who are 8, 6, and 4 years old. Okay, somebody. I have books. I'm getting ready to release another book, so I got to work on that. We're getting ready to release Sis, I Need Help with My Finances. So I'm about to release another book pretty soon called Sis, I Need Help with My Finances. And it is going to be a book that is going to teach you not only about budgeting, not only is it going to teach you about kingdom principles concerning finances, but we're going to release this book and it's going to be absolutely amazing. It's going to be another, can I go ahead and speak over this book that I ain't even wrote yet that it's going to be a bestseller? So I'm getting ready to release another bestseller, which will be out hopefully. No, matter of fact, we're going to go ahead and say it. It's going to be released in December, between December and January. So we're going to release Sis, I Need Help with My Finances, because I am a wealth builder. That is who I am. I am called to build wealth. I am called to that. I can't separate my identity from it. You know, I host masterclasses too. I got another masterclass, which is coming out, which is going to be December 3rd. So December 3rd, I'm doing another masterclass and I'm going to teach you how to master your mind. Why? Because not only have I learned biblically how to master your mind, but I went to school to be a neurolinguistics programming practitioner. So that way I could take all of that information and then teach Christians how to use their subconscious mind. I went to school to be a life and success coach, not so I could be effective in the world, but so I could be effective in the kingdom. Y'all don't even know it. I'm getting ready. I'm about to take some more financing classes. Why? Because I am passionate about wealth. I'm passionate about compound interest. I'm passionate about the rule of 72. I'm passionate about teaching people how to be wealthy. That is a big deal to me because I've been there. I'm passionate about, why do I talk about depression so much? Because I was depressed. I was suicidal. You don't know how many times I tried to commit suicide. Praise God that He kept my life. Thank God He kept my life. But I'm passionate about these areas. And so I have my mentorship program, which is my Sis Tribe. And so I have mentorship students. And then the Lord just spoke to me to start discipling, I have pastors who are under me. So I have pastors who call me their pastors, who has branches in other countries and stuff like that. Can I just go ahead and be real and just be about as humble can get? Can I just be humble? I'm 28 years old. I'm 28 years old. If you think I thought my life was going to be like this at 28 years old, I'll tell you in a minute. Give me a second. But my life being, I'm 28 years old. And to be doing all this at 28 years old for God, my life, can I be real with y'all? Back in April, I wanted Takiya's way. And I wanted to be, I wanted to be a Christian, but I also kind of wanted to be in the world too. Y'all know I'm transparent. I don't care. Because when back in April, when I was doing life coaching and stuff like that, I wanted to do life coaching, but I wanted to do it my way. And my way was the world. I wanted to go for the world, but God said, no, you're going for my people. Because Takiya, I didn't call you to the world. I called you to my people. So I've changed all of my doings to where now I coach Christian women. I coach Christian women how to be blessed in their businesses. There's people on here who's had a session with me. When I tell you, those sessions are just, when you come to a session with me, it ain't just you gonna get what you need in your business, but we put God up in that thing. And when I remember the days when I was trying to do it my way, I would only, come on, I had to get up out that lukewarmness, Grace. I had to get up out that lukewarmness, and God spit me out. Yes, he did. He spit me out in April when I came off of a conference flat broke. Yeah, been there. So, but, you know, in coming out of that, right, the Lord, when I tell y'all, you can sign up for a session. Matter of fact, I'm going to talk to y'all, and I'm going to allow y'all to look at the link in my bio while I talk to y'all, because that way you get context, okay? Because, so I'm going to talk, but I'm also going to do announcements all at one time, okay? So I'm going to talk, and I'm going to talk about announcements at the same time, okay? But, so if you want to sign up for any of these things that I'm talking about, because I want to establish purpose, okay? So I am having Master Your Mind Masterclass. If you want to sign up for Master Your Mind Masterclass, all you do is just click right here. This is my Linktr.ee/Takiya Arevalo. So you just click right here and stuff, and it's going to take you to go sign up for my Master Your Mind Masterclass, which is only $97. Then if you want to get healthy with me and Pastor Eli, you can click here, and it's going to take you to the way that we do that. Also, Lonnie, I'm going to reach out to you today because I have not forgotten. If you want to join my sis tribe, Grace, I'm going to tell you something. Back in June is when I started on TikTok, right? July 16th, I went viral. In a matter between June is when I got serious about it. So from June and then July, all of a sudden I went viral and just hit 10K. I was going to do it my way. God came in, blew my mind. And now I have over 90 some thousand followers. But this was only in a few months. This ain't happened in a long time. This was in months. If you let God do what he wants to do, he will blow your mind. You sent me an email about my assistant? What are you talking about? About my assistant disobeying him? Like, about being an assistant? Or I don't know what you're trying to say. Okay, so if you want to join my sis tribe, you could join my sis tribe here. Also, too. So, yeah, like I say, so I have a tribe. You can get in my sis tribe. It's a mentorship program. So you can get in my mentorship program. You can buy your prayer journal here. So I have a prayer journal, which is a bestseller. And you can go buy it right here. Oh, okay. Then also, too, you can book a coaching session right here. It is. Let me put it in the comments, okay? Hold on. You can put all this in the comments. /Takiya. Also, I will have a link up pretty soon today. By the end of today, I will have a link up so you can go purchase my World Builders Masterclass, the replay. I'll have a link up so you can go purchase that replay. And I'm going to tell you something. That replay is $75 just for what you're going to make out of it, just the stocks alone. Yeah. So, look, you can book a coaching session with me here. So if you like to book a coaching session, you do that here. So, y'all, me and Elijah, which we're getting ready to go do, if you want to go and shop Bougie Sis Boutique, let me show you how to do that, okay? Because I saw some people who said that they wanted my t-shirt, okay? So let me show you how to go shop that, okay? So we own Bougie Sis Boutique, okay? You can book a session for your business or whatever you want to book it for. So, and everything is still on sale because, listen, y'all know I still ain't had time to change my website. Pray for me, okay? So I got to honor it. So also, y'all, look. Sis, I Need Help is available for pre-sale. We had a lady buy one already. and stuff, but they're $20, and you're gonna receive a signed copy of my book. So the Sis I Need Help book, her guide to deeper prayer, y'all, the signed copy is now available. So it's gonna be signed, and then also too, I'm gonna write a special message for you in your book and stuff. So it will be personal for you. So you can go purchase that, and they start shipping out on Thursday, okay? Now, let's get back to the other stuff. So, this is our Christmas line. So, we do have some Christmas stuff, y'all. This is one of our hot seller shirts right here. This is our affirmation shirt. And it says, you are worthy and you are enough. This is one of the shirts that sells out the most. And so, also, we have our Created for a Purpose shirt, y'all. So, you can go purchase your Created for a Purpose shirt, y'all. This is our Esther shirt. I love this shirt. I'm gonna get it closer. This is our Esther shirt. It says, perhaps you were created for such a time as this. And so you can go purchase that shirt, y'all. We have our, this is the shirt that I am wearing right now. So you see the red version of it, but I'm wearing the tan version of it, okay? So the tan version of it. Okay, yeah. So the tan version of it is what I have on today. God is going to display you in front of those who try to defeat you, okay? So all you need to do is go right there. This is, she's both hellfire and holy water. They come out on Thursday night. Thursday.